Once upon a time, there was a kingdom called Srimandapuram. The kingdom had a king named Vishwakdat, and he had two sons called Anegan and Vishwaksen. He also had a daughter named Anderi. He made sure that he raised both his sons and his daughter with the same love and affection. One fine day,
"My sons, I would like to give you the responsibility of looking after my nation. Anderi, I would like you to stay with me and follow my orders."
"Father, I should suggest that I shall look after the eastern part of the nation and my brother shall look after the western part of the nation."
"That is a great suggestion, my son. Both of you must look after our nation, just like Raman and Lakshman. Okay?"
"Sure, father. We will make sure to make you proud in every way we can."
Then, both the sons of the king left the palace and went on to follow their duties. The king also had a friend named Sudarshan. He was a very dear friend for the king. But recently, he has not been paying his taxes regularly. The king was quite worried about this situation. He then assigns his daughter Anderi to look into this situation. His daughter investigates and then reports to the king. His daughter says, "Father, I'm here to report to you regarding the omission of taxes by your friend Sudarshan."
"Sure, my daughter. Please tell me what is going on with him. I would really like to know why he didn't pay tax."
"The reason why he has not been able to pay taxes recently is because his land has apparently been cursed by a demon. His land is not raising crops or being fruitful for farming anymore. The people who are around it say that it has been haunted by a devil. It is also residing next to a cave which is called as the Demon's Cave. This is the reason why your friend Sudarshan is unable to pay his taxes. This is what happened, my father."
"Oh my God, why didn't Sudarshan tell me this before? I am quite disappointed. Please let the gods call Sudarshan and bring him to me right away. Make sure you find out what the issue in that land is."
"I shall do as you say, father. I shall leave now. I shall solve this issue right away, my father."
"Sure, my child."
After a while, Sudarshan is invited to the palace by all the guards. Sudarshan then meets the king. The king looks at Sudarshan and says,
"My friend, do I really have to invite you to see you? Why did you not get in touch with me? Don't you know that I would help you in any way I can when you are in the trouble? Why did you not trust me?"
"My king, I am sorry. I didn't want to be a burden to you. I apologize for not calling you."
As they both were speaking and having a pleasant, friendly conversation, the king's daughter Anderi enters the vicinity. Sudarshan says this to king.
"My king, I apologize for not paying my recent taxes immediately. I will make sure that I pay it to you as soon as I can."
"Did I mention that to you right now? Why did you have to bring that up? By the way, your entire nation's biggest source of income was the wheat that was raised in your lands. Whatever happened to the crops and the wheat that would be farmed in your land, wouldn't this affect your nation financially?"
"I understand what are you saying, my king, but our people are afraid to even farm or go to that land. They somehow think that the land is cursed and barren."
After patiently waiting for a while, the king's daughter Anderi interrupts and says this, "I apologize to interrupt both of your conversations. I would like to tell you all the reason behind the problems that Sudarshan's land is facing. The problem that your land is facing is not because of a ghost, demon or devil. The problem with your lands is because of a naughty young child."
"A naughty child? What are you saying? How is it that the land becomes bad and because of a naughty child?"
"There was a well in a place which people today call a cave. This well made sure that the entire land is fruitful and green, were very sufficient for the entire population of the people living in that land. The reason why the well turned into a cave and turned the entire land into a barren land because of a young naughty child."
"How is a young naughty child responsible for everything as big as this? Would you please explain us?"
"I shall explain that to you. A long time ago, three children were playing hide and seek. In that, one child went and hid inside a well. That well was a well where the people would come and fetch water to water their fields and lands. But since that boy went and hid in that well, he started making noises to divert his other two friends from finding him. The other two friends were befuddled and afraid. They went back to the village and started spreading rumors about ghosts being present in that well. After that rumor spread like a wild fire, people slowly stopped going to that well. This turned that well and the place, it was situated in an abandoned cave. And because people couldn't fetch water, the entire lands became dry and barren. This affected the plants, the trees, the crops and the wheat. Andheri finishes explaining how the land is not possessed by any demon whatsoever and that the land is barren and ruined because of a young boy. After listening to everything, Sudarshan felt really bad and King was quite shocked and said,
"My God, just because of a young naughty boy, the entire land is ruined and barren."
"I know that, my king. I do not know how I will be able to solve this problem. I thought this situation has occurred due to lack of rain. This is entirely my fault and I will take full responsibility for it."
Sudarshan feels quite sad about this. The king then tries to console him and says like this,
"Please do not be in sorrow, my friend. Now we know what the truth is. We shall solve this issue immediately."
As the two friends were speaking to each other, the king's two sons, Anegan and Vishwaksin, enter the place after finishing their work.
"Greetings, father. It is so great to see friends like both of you together. But I doubt that this meeting is an auspicious event because your expressions tell me otherwise. Is there any problem, father?"
"Shall I tell you? Come up, my son. You must find the solution to the problem for me."
"Yes, come on, my father. Please believe in us. Tell us the thing. Me and my brother will fix the problem as soon as we can."
The king explains everything that his daughter told him to the two sons. He explains how the land of Sudarshan has become barren and ruined. The two sons listens to this and says like this,
"My king, we would like to take this opportunity to solve this problem that Sudarshan is facing. Please let us make you proud. Me and my brother will solve this problem right away."
Then the two sons travel to the barren, ruined land of Sudarshan. Once they reach there, they look around it and they are baffled by how dry and unoccupied this land is.
"Brother, come on, how are we going to be able to convince people to come back to this land? Clearly they think it is possessed and occupied by a demon."
"I do not know. Come on, brother. They will still be stuck to their old beliefs. We have to find a way to get them to come here."
"Maybe we can lure them in saying that there is a treasure here. That seems to be the only way to get them out. Once we announce that there is a treasure here, I believe that people would come back and make this land fruitful again."
"But before we do that, we have to make sure we know exactly what is in that cave. For that, we must first go and investigate."
The two brothers keep walking towards the abandoned cave. The land is about 1,000 acres and right in the middle of two big mountains, there is the abandoned and forbidden cave. Once they entered, it is pretty dark. And as they kept going inside deeper and deeper, it becomes very difficult for both the brothers. At one point, they take out two diamonds from their pockets and they place it on the ground. And then they return back to Sudarshan and says like this,
"Me and my brother have both investigated the cave, my king, and as far as we know, we were unable to find anything that is suspicious or even resembling a demon or a devil. In order to get your people back into that land, I suggest that you create a contest where people should go inside. You should give them a reward."
"Yes. Once the people realize that there is nothing there in the cave, this will remove all the old beliefs that the people have and they will go back to their land."
"I shall do that right away. You both are very smart and effective in what you do."
After the king commanded and mentioned that people would have to go inside the cave and come back, there were two brothers, Ramayya and Bhimayya. Ramayya says this to Bhimayya,
"Has this king got mad? Why would he want us to go inside the cave? Doesn't he already know that the cave is possessed by demons and devils? Why is he playing with our lives?"
"I know, brother, but I am still interested in this contest because there is a huge reward prize. Why can't we just try it? We might be very successful in it."
"Look, you're absolutely crazy. Why would you want to try such thing? I would never do that. That is a demon in that cave. If you go there, you will definitely lose your life. Don't be stupid."
Both Ramayya and Bhimayya were good brothers who loved each other. Ramayya was a polite, kind and disciplined individual, where Bhimayya was eccentric, naughty and jobless. Ramayya's wife hated Bhimayya as she could not stand him. He would always do something to irritate her but would be completely unintentional. One day, Ramayya's wife becomes very upset and says this to Ramayya, "You know what your brother did today? He went to my father's land with his useless dog and messed up and ruined everything. Are you going to say or can I say?"
Why are you so harsh on him? He is just a young boy. Don't be so rude. Imagine if he was your son, would you be treating him this way? Please be nice to him.
If he was my son, I would have thrown him out of the house a long time ago. I'm sick of him and I'm tired of him. Instead of him being here, you might as well just send him to that abandoned cave where he can die. After hearing the scoldings of the wife, Ramaya leaves angrily. Bhimaya, who has listening to everything quietly on the side, is now extremely sad and angry. Bhimaya then takes his adopted dog to the cave as he is sick and tired of life and feels like he would rather die than live like this anymore.
This cave is so scary and dark. I didn't know if I should go there. But if I go there and if I die, at least I wouldn't have to live like this anymore. But if I come back alive, I can get the prize from the king. Either way, this visit would be beneficial for me.
As Bhimaya kept going deeper and deeper in the cave with his dog becomes restless and goes way too far inside the deep cave. After a while, his dogs come back with a diamond in its mouth. Bhimaya takes the diamond and is quite shocked to see the diamonds with his dog. He then takes the diamond and he go back to his brother Ramaya and shows it to him and says like this.
What is this? Have you stolen this from somewhere? How did you get this? Tell me, this seems like a very precious diamond.
Bhimaya proceeds to tell everything that had occurred until then in the cave. After hearing all this, Ramaya is shocked and says,
this seems like a very precious diamond.
Ramaya then goes to the King Sudarshan in order to receive the reward and he says,
my king, here I have the diamond which was in the cave. I'm here to retrieve the prize that you had mentioned before, as I have completely traveled inside the cave.
As Ramaya says to the king, listening to this, both the brothers Vishwaksen and Anegan are quite confused as they remember keeping two diamonds instead of one. Vishwaksen, the elder brother, says this to Ramaya.
Ramaya, please tell me the truth. Did you actually go inside the cave or did someone else go inside the cave? If you do not tell me the truth, I shall chop your head off.
Fearing the punishment threatened by the prince, Ramaya blurts out all the truths.
I apologize, sir. I did not go to the cave, but my brother went to the cave. He is the one that brought me this diamond.
Come on, get your brother immediately right now.
After a while, Ramaya then goes and brings his brother to the king. Sudarshan says to Bhimaya,
Bhimaya, how did you get this diamond? Did you actually go to the cave?
Yes, my king. I went inside the cave and I found this diamond myself with the help of my dog. He ran first and he retrieved it back for me.
Splendid, Bhimaya. You are brave. I want you to go out and tell everybody in the village that there is nothing in the cave and the cave is not possessed by a demon.
Sudarshan then start announcing in every part of the nation that the cave is completely ordinary and there is no such thing as a ghost or a demon which is possessing the land. This becomes a pleasant news all around the nation. Bhimaya is invited. Ramaya is also felicitated. The king says,
Bhimaya, I respect your valor and your courage, which is why I am giving you a huge price of money and also of land nearby the cave. Wherever you can farm and cultivate crops of our nation, I will be rewarding acres of land to anybody that is willing to farm in the forbidden land, which is nearby the cave.
This makes several changes in the nation and the land which was once ruined and barren starts to become fruitful and starts to serve the nation. All the old beliefs of the ghosts and demons were now driven away by the simple facts that the cave is nothing but an abandoned well. People start farming in that land, which solves all the problem for the king. The king called Vishwaksen and Anegan and says this to them.
I would like to thank both of you for solving my problem. What seemed to be an impossible task to fix has been completely solved by the both of you. All these old beliefs and all these age-old tales should be demolished as they serve no purpose for the practical way of living. The fact that you both were able to find a solution to my problem, which had been there for years in a matter of days, is quite astounding.
After a while, the people started farming again in those forbidden lands and started cultivating several crops of wheat, which earned them a lot of income, which state then used to send taxes to the king. This solved all their financial problems and the land was fruitful again. If you like this story, do like it, share it. For more news stories, please subscribe our news stories book English YouTube channel.